Hi, this is Brian Mertens from naturementor.com, and in this video I'm going to be talking about the five voices of the birds. And the five voices of the birds is a frame of reference for understanding bird language, that the five voices of the birds gives you a way to sift through the great diversity of bird vocalizations that occurs out in nature, and allows you to recognize the difference between when birds are in doing their maintenance behavior versus when there's an alarm for something like a predator. And what this enables you to do is, when you go outside, be able to listen to the sounds that the birds make and hear when the hawk moves through the landscape or when the cat is sneaking along the edge of the forest, just out of sight. The first voice of the birds is called the song. And the song is a diverse group of sounds. They're pretty easy to distinguish, and if you listen to bird CDs, like the CDs that they make with the different vocalizations on them, the song is often the one that's referred to most commonly. It's a sign when you hear a bird singing outside, it's a sign that bird feels safe. Meaning it's not worrying about predators, and so birds will sing when they're setting up their territories or when they're attracting a mate. And so if you hear song, that's a good indicator that bird, at least at the moment, is feeling relatively safe. The second voice of the birds is the companion call, and companion calls are often in bird tapes referred to as like a chip or like a tack, but there's a real variation. They can be quiet or loud, depending on how far away the companions are. But basically, it's just any vocalization that's made between allied members of the same species, so a mated pair or a flock, flock calls. And they can be similar to alarms in certain contexts, and so it's important. This is an important voice to know in order to be able to tell the difference, that you're not thinking that every call that you hear out there is an alarm. A lot of the calls that you hear out there might be companion calls. So they're often made while the birds are feeding and kind of moving through their winter territories. You'll hear chickadees and that kind of stuff doing them a lot. So this is another sign that the birds are feeling safe, that they're not under any immediate pressure from a predator. So the third voice of the birds is territorial aggression, and this voice is pretty crucial for being able to interpret alarms in springtime. Territorial aggression often can sound a lot like alarms because it's just a really intense response. And basically, when the birds are setting up their territories in spring, you might see robins kind of scuffling over their boundary territories, and they'll make a lot of intense vocalizations around that. But the thing to look for is that it's happening between two members of the same species, or between two birds that aren't a threat to each other, but that compete for territory and that kind of stuff, and food. Well, the fourth voice of the birds is juvenile begging, and this voice is made by inexperienced birds who are begging their parents to feed them, and it's sort of this this ongoing chatter that they do to entice their parents to feed them. And this voice is not reliably alarm or safety, meaning that inexperienced birds don't necessarily know bird language in the way that their parents do, and so when a predator is in the area, like a hawk, they won't necessarily know to stop vocalizing or to do anything different, and that kind of gives away their location, and so they're pretty easy to succumb to predation at that stage. And so I use knowledge of juvenile begging to understand just like what nesting stage the birds are at, because there will be a lot of corresponding predator behavior with that. And so if you hear juvenile begging, it's not necessarily a sign that the birds are feeling safe. It's more an indicator of where the birds are at in their life cycle. And it can be confusing if you're thinking that you're listening for alarms, but you're hearing juvenile begging doesn't necessarily tell you that there aren't alarms around. So the fifth voice of the bird is the alarm. And I've kind of been talking about it all the way through. But an alarm is basically any vocal response to a predator. And that can be, that can exist within a huge range of vocalizations. Some alarms are very high-pitched. Some alarms are a lot lower and easy to locate. Some alarms can be really loud, and other alarms can actually be fairly quiet. Alarms will sometimes cover a really large area, and at other times they'll be more localized in a particular area. And so bird language as a skill, and especially interpreting alarms, is looking at all these different dynamics to be able to tell the difference in the sound of a landscape when there's a hawk causing alarms versus when there's a bobcat causing alarms, or when there's a raccoon causing alarms. And all these different animals will actually cause a different size, shape, pitch, and variance that changes over time. So you can learn to identify different species by these sounds. So thanks for watching this video on the five voices of the birds. If you like this video, I'd love to hear your comments. And stay tuned for more videos coming in the next few weeks on bird language.